Farm Fresh. Two words that have never been more true than when describing Wright's Dairy Farm in North Smithfield. Milk, cakes, and baked goods, always natural, always fresh, and always local.
We're a fifth generation dairy farm here in Northern Rhode Island. And my great-grandfather started milking cows here in the 1900s. My grandfather sold milk directly to customers in the area, home delivery. He was the milkman. My parents soon after opened a store here on the farm, and then the bakery was born soon after that. As our family has grown, so has the business. We're like four businesses in one now. We have our farm here that we milk the cows. We have the dairy where we process the milk, and we have our bakery that we make all of our own baked goods here, and then the store. Everything that we produce here on the farm is sold here in our store on the farm. That's what makes us unique, that we're able to produce the milk, process the milk, and sell it all here on the farm.
In addition to churning out wonderful, wholesome products every day, Wright's can also be a fun and educational experience for the entire family.
Everybody loves coming to the farm because they like to see the cows, and then they like to go into the store and then buy the milk that comes from the cows.
Here in Wright's Dairy, we have approximately 120 cows. The barn is cleaned twice a day. The lactating cows are fed a complete diet of corn silage, hay, and grain. We milk our cows twice a day at 3:30 in the morning and 3 o'clock in the afternoon, every day, 7 days a week, holidays, Christmas, every day of the year. In order for a cow to continually produce milk, she has to be bred and have a baby at least once a year to continue to produce milk naturally. When we bring our cows in to be milked here in the milking parlor, the cows will come from the freestall barn in the back, they will come up the alley, come into the milking parlor, and they will be attached to a milking machine. That milking machine will take about approximately 5 to 10 minutes for that cow to give her full amount of milk. And that'll come out to about, just about 10 gallons per cow per day. As soon as she's done being milked, she will exit the parlor and return back to the freestall barn. When a cow comes in to be milked, she actually has a ID collar, and all that information about her activity, how much milk she has given, is recorded. All our cows have a medical file in our computer, so we can monitor the cow's health very closely and take excellent care of all the girls.
Taking extra care to make sure all of their cows are healthy and happy keeps that milk pumping, which keeps the dairy very busy.
There's a lot of steps involved from getting the milk from the milk tank down in the milking parlor up to our store where we sell it on the retail shelves. It starts by going through a separator, which also clarifies the milk, where we can either pull the cream off of the milk to get skim 2%, or we can leave the cream on the milk and get whole milk. Then it gets pumped over to our pasteurizer, slightly heated, and goes through our homogenizer. Homogenizing is the process of taking the milk proteins and forcing them together with the fat proteins, so everything is glued together, otherwise you'd have that slick layer of cream on top of the milk. From there, it gets rapidly chilled before being bottled, capped, rinsed off, and then sent down to either our store or we pack orders and have them shipped out across the state. Our milk lasts just as long as any other milk. The difference is that in the grocery store, it might sit on the shelves or in storage for up to a week before it's actually available to customers. Whereas here, we're taking the milk, we're processing it, and we're putting it on the shelves almost the same day.
And having fresh milk right on site benefits Wright's customers in other ways as well.
The bakery was started here at Wright's Dairy Farm based on ingredients. It was a necessity to utilize all the milk and cream that they had coming from their dairy. So they were trying to create products at that time to utilize those ingredients that they had readily available that they were already producing. So we do a lot of custard items, eclairs are a huge seller, and then we also do a lot of whipped cream pastry. That's our main staple, that we do whipped cream pastry all year long. So the cows give milk every day, we have whipped cream every day. The product line here at Wright's Dairy Farm consists of everything from breakfast items to wedding cakes. So on a given day, we might come in and we start with breakfast items such as muffins and Danish and meltaways and pecan rolls, and then we'll move into pizza, broccoli pies, Italian bread. At the end of production, we would run into cake, where we're producing cake for all the orders that we might have for the next day.
A genuine staple of Rhode Island, Wright's is always growing to serve its customers better in the future without ever losing sight of their own rich history.
Currently, we're standing in a building that was built last year. It was built as a replica to the barn that was here for 100 years, housing and milking cows. It's something that we can use to expand our business, and we're actually baking in this building, but it was such a staple and a landmark in the community. We felt it was really important to make sure that it replicated what was originally here so that the experience for the Wright's Dairy Farm customer doesn't really change. We really concentrate on our community and those retail customers that are coming in to visit agriculture that doesn't really exist much anymore in Rhode Island.
I think what keeps the customers coming back here to Wright's Dairy Farm is the experience. They come to experience the farm and where their food comes from.
It's important to us to keep customers coming back to the farm. We want to make sure we offer them a quality product at reasonable prices with friendly service.